Good day. Welcome to First Take exclusively on YouTube. Stephen A., did you wear a new suit because you knew Tuesday was YouTube day? I do have to admit, my dad texted me during the show, and he's like, does Stephen A. have a new suit every day? My goodness. My lesson, that's what it is to be Stephen A. Smith.
You tell Papa Qerim, I mean, the brother just, I just try to dress as sharp as I could possibly be because I know that working with his daughter, I got to look the part to hold up my end of the bargain. Tell Papa Qerim that.
I appreciate that. All right, guys. Yes. Guys, it's just me and you. I forgot Shannon's gone. Stephen A., we got playing games tonight. We're talking playoffs. So let's dive into it. I want to start with LeBron and Steph. They're going to fight for their playoff lives, not against each other. The Lakers taking on the Pelicans while the Warriors will play the Kings. Then tomorrow, it's the Eastern where the Heat will take on the Sixers and the Hawks play the Bulls. Taking a closer look at this playoff picture, where during the season it was all about the Celtics, obviously, who won the conference by 14 games, large margin. So the winner of tomorrow's play-in game between the Heat and the Sixers will be the 7th seed and play the Knicks in the first round. Stephen A.'s Knicks got the 2 seed, which is impressive. The loser will play the Hawks Bulls winner to get the 8 seed and play the Celtics. It's rough. SA, in these playoffs, who's the biggest threat to Boston? Because right now it feels like men amongst boys.
I think it's the New York Knicks, and I've stated that, and I think they'll ultimately meet in the conference finals. We can't summarily dismiss the Miami Heat. We understand they've been in the conference finals three of the last 4 years, along with two NBA finals appearances. But the health of Jimmy Butler has come into question. The health of Tyler Hero is always in question. And Bam Adebayo hasn't been himself. And so when I look at it from that perspective, that gives New York an edge. When I look at the Milwaukee Bucks, they've looked discombobulated and out of sync all season long. That hasn't changed. And so, for me, I look at the Orlando Magic, the Indiana Pacers, relatively young squads, even though Indiana picking up a Pascal Siakam goes a long way. I understand that. But with the Knicks and the way that they're playing defense, the way the kind of year that Jalen Brunson is having, OG Anunoby 20-3 when he is in the lineup, their defensive efficiency was at ranked 20th. He arrives there, they're number one. And so I look at all of those things and I say to myself, that would be the most formidable threat to the Boston Celtics because the Knicks defend. They make every outing a tough one, and I think that's what this comes down to. That's why I'm going with the Knicks as the toughest challenge to the Boston Celtics in the Eastern Conference at this moment.
All right, let's head to the West Coast. So everyone's going to be trying to stop, obviously, Nikola Jokic and the Nuggets from a chance of a repeat title. Kind of similar situation, I would say, with Boston in the East. So the winner of tonight's play-in game between the Lakers and Pelicans, they'll be the 7th seed. They play the Nuggets in the first round. The loser, they play the Warriors-Kings winner to get that 8th seed and play the Thunder. Hope you got all that at home. Stephen A., who's the biggest threat to the Nuggets right now in the West? The West is thick.
Well, to me, when I look at it, I tell you, once upon a time, I would say the Los Angeles Lakers because of their size. Obviously, Anthony Davis kind of having the kind of year that he has. LeBron James playing the way that he plays. But I got to confess to you, as I look at a team like the Dallas Mavericks. Once upon a time, it was even Minnesota in that mix because of the size on the defensive line. Obviously, Jokic is your primary option. If you're the Denver Nuggets, you look at the size that Minnesota throws at you with Rudy Gobert and Karl Anthony Towns, and that makes you say them. But with the pickup of Gafford, with Lively coming back, with Kyrie Irving and Luka Doncic playing the way that they're playing, I don't have any problem with anybody who believes right now they're the elite threat to the Nuggets, because guess what? How are you going to stop them? That's a huge, huge question mark for anybody going up against the Dallas Mavericks right now because of the explosiveness of a Kyrie Irving along with a Luka Doncic. Okay. So that's right now, at this particular moment, I'll throw that out there, the Dallas Mavericks.
Okay, Stephen A., I'm going to kind of call an audible here on this last one. Obviously, there's a bit of a different feel with these playoffs, almost as if we're ushering in a new guard or a new generation with so many young stars in contention. We got Shai Gilgeous-Alexander becoming a household name. His whole young Thunder squad, they took the 1 seed in the West. We got Ant Edwards, the T-Wolves, Luka, Zion, and a few others. But what I want to know from you is, who are you, Stephen A., really going to have your eye on? Like, who do you really want to watch their performance? Hey, are they going to show up and show out?
Well, I brought up the Dallas Mavericks, that's one, because Luke has been knocking on the door. The man nearly averaged a 34-point triple-double this year. But I'm also going to look at the Oklahoma City Thunder. I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander is the league MVP. They're the second youngest team in the NBA. When you look at the personnel they have, you kind of scratch your head and wonder why Sam Presti didn't go out and get a big. Somebody that just rebounds and defend, an Andre Drummond of the world, a big body like a DeMarcus Cousins or somebody. Why didn't you just go out and get somebody like that? Because when you look at this young squad and what they bring to the table, the way they're capable of performing, perimeter shooting, athleticism, young, fresh legs, a level of fervor that most teams can't match all the time. That's why even though they're the second youngest team in the league, they were the number one seed. They are the number one seed out of the Western Conference. These dudes are something to behold and to be reckoned with. And I'm going to keep my eyes on Oklahoma City because they've got a bright future with an abundance of picks and all of this other stuff. I'm interested in seeing what they're going to do with the squad they presently have.
All right, good stuff. Okay, if you at home want to see more Stephen A., of course, check out the Stephen A. Smith Show. That's right on YouTube. You can subscribe, get all his videos there. And, of course, NBA Countdown on Wednesday. And then they're going to have the doubleheader of the NBA games. Thank you so much for watching First Take Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. on ESPN. We'll be back tomorrow breaking down the first two play-in games. See you then. SA, have a great day.